In today's world, computers have become so prevalent that one can easily take them for granted. The device you're watching this video on right now, be it your phone or your desktop computer, is the culmination of centuries of critical thinking, invention, and innovation. And today, we're going to take a deep dive into the history of the computer to uncover just how we got here. Mechanisms to assist in computing have existed in some capacity for thousands of years. One of humanity's very earliest computing devices to assist with calculations was the abacus, which originated around 2000 BCE in what is becoming a channel regular at this point, ancient Mesopotamia. It's amazing just how many things have their roots in this civilization. The abacus consisted of a frame with rods of rigid wires along which beads or stones could slide. Each column represented a different place value, allowing the mechanism to help with addition, subtraction, multiplication, or division. The abacus played a pivotal role in commerce, astronomy, and various mathematical applications in ancient civilizations like the Sumerians, Egyptians, Greeks, and Chinese. It was simple and effective, making it a tool that would find use for centuries to come. Another important discovery was the Antikythera mechanism of around 100 BCE, which was an ancient Greek analog computer believed to have been used for astronomical calculations. Discovered in a shipwreck off the coast of Greece, it contained a complex system of dials and gears that could track celestial movements. There have been many other notable devices that assisted with calculations and mathematics over the years. These included the slide rule, consisting of two logarithmic scales that could slide against each other, the astrolabe, an instrument that could tell the local time and also assist with navigation using celestial bodies, and various calculators such as the Napier's Bones, Pascaline, and Leibniz's Stepped Reckoner. In the early 1800s, Joseph Marie Jacquard developed a loom that used punched cards to control the patterns woven into fabric. This innovation allowed for the automation of complex weaving processes, but more importantly, the technology demonstrated the potential of punched cards as a means of providing instructions to a machine, which set the stage for a major contribution to the world of computers. This major contribution came in the form of Charles Babbage, a brilliant English mathematician and inventor, often regarded as the father of the computer. In the early 19th century, he conceived the idea of the analytical engine, a mechanical device capable of performing many mathematical functions. The analytical engine was essentially an entire century ahead of its time. It made use of the same punched cards as the Jacquard loom for input, had a mechanical arithmetic logic unit, a memory unit that could store and retrieve data, and was even capable of output in the form of punched cards that could be read later. Many of these functions were so advanced that in some form they have made it into the very computers that we use today. Although Babbage was unable to finish his machine due to lack of funding and other issues, he laid the groundwork for all modern computing concepts, and we would be far behind today if not for his work. The next major steps in computer development came in the form of mechanical inventions that were capable of complex computation tasks. One of these came from Hermann Hollerith, an American inventor and statistician, who revolutionized data processing with the invention of the tabulating machine. His machine used punched cards to efficiently process and analyze large amounts of data. Hollerith's machine worked so well that it was famously employed for use in the 1890 US Census, significantly reducing the time and effort required for tabulation of population data. Although the use case of his machine was more specific, Hollerith's work was nevertheless a breakthrough in the field of automated data processing, further cementing the prospects of modern computing. Then, in the 1930s, British mathematician extraordinaire Alan Turing introduced the concept of the Turing machine. This was a theoretical device consisting of an infinite tape and a read-write head that could make use of this tape. It could perform a set of basic operations, such as reading, writing, and moving left and right on the tape. Turing demonstrated that his machine could, in principle, use its basic set of operations to perform any possible computation that any other computing machine could do. This laid the foundation for the theory of computation and is considered the cornerstone of modern computer science, because it formalized the definition of what it means to compute something. Turing also worked on the design of the Automatic Computing Engine, or ACE, an early electronic stored program computer concept. Although not built during his lifetime, his work went on to greatly influence the development of future computing machines. The next big step in the development of computers was the mass exodus from the electromechanical components to true electronic components, like transistors and integrated circuits. In 1945, John W. Mauchly and J. Presper Eckert at the University of Pennsylvania finally developed the world's first fully electronic general-purpose computer, the Electronic Numerical Integrator and Computer, or ENIAC. ENIAC used vacuum tubes, which served as electronic switches to perform computations. Its primary purpose was to perform complex calculations for scientific and military applications, such as artillery trajectory calculations and nuclear weapon design. It was a massive machine that took up the space of an entire room and consumed a great deal of power. This was a shortcoming that was to be overcome in the coming years with a breakthrough. That breakthrough came just a couple of years later in the form of the invention of the transistor in 1947 by John Bardeen, Walter Brattain, and William Shockley at Bell Laboratories. This innovation revolutionized electronic devices, as the bulky, power-hungry vacuum tubes of past devices could now be replaced by smaller, more reliable, and more energy-efficient transistors which acted as electronic amplifiers and switches. Shortly after that, in 1950, came the inception of the integrated circuit. This involved placing multiple transistors, resistors, and capacitors on a single silicon chip. The invention of the integrated circuit by Jack Kilby and Robert Noyce was a monumental leap forward in miniaturizing electronic components. All this led to what's known as the mainframe era, in which mainframe computers, large, powerful, and highly reliable machines, became the dominant computing technology of the era and the backbone of many organizations' infrastructure. Mainframes were capable of processing vast amounts of data and running multiple tasks simultaneously. IBM, one of the pioneering companies in computing even to this day, played a crucial role in popularizing and standardizing mainframe computing. The introduction of the IBM System 360 series in the 1960s marked a significant milestone in this era. IBM continued to innovate in this space in the years that followed, introducing new models with improved processing power, memory capacity, and input-output systems. Following the success and rapid miniaturization of computers over the past few decades, the technology was now poised to make itself available in households for personal use. For starters, in 1975, the Altair 8800 was introduced by Micro Instrumentation and Telemetry Systems, or MITS. It was one of the first commercially successful personal computers. It featured an Intel 8080 microprocessor and was sold as a kit that users assembled themselves. This approach encouraged enthusiasts to learn about computer hardware. Then came along Apple and Microsoft, the pioneers of personal computing. Apple Inc., founded by Steve Jobs, Steve Wozniak, and Ronald Wayne, introduced the Apple I in 1976 and Apple II in 1977, the latter of which was a fully assembled personal computer with a color display and a user-friendly interface. It became immensely popular, particularly in the education sector. Microsoft, founded by Bill Gates and Paul Allen, played a key role in the personal computing revolution by developing software for early PCs. Their most notable product was the BASIC programming language. In 1984, things took an even more massively user-friendly turn when Apple launched the Macintosh, which featured an extremely intuitive and easy-to-learn graphical user interface. This revolutionary interface, with its windows and icons, was a major departure from the generally unapproachable and daunting command line interfaces of the past. Microsoft quickly followed suit with the release of Windows 1.0 in 1985, which, although wasn't as user-friendly as Macintosh at first in early versions, would receive several updates and improvements to its GUI to make it easier to use. As you can imagine, personal computers changed the game for all business operations. Tasks like word processing, spreadsheet management, and data entry were more streamlined and efficient than ever before. In education, computers have become an invaluable tool for teaching and learning in an interactive environment. From there, the rest is history. The modern era of computing came to pass, which is characterized by an increase in computing power by several orders of magnitude, as well as groundbreaking advancements in hardware, software, and networking. So, that was the story of how the idea of computing went from moving beads on an abacus thousands of years ago to performing billions of computations per second today. The mind-numbing amount of progress made in the world of computing in the past century alone has led to its widespread integration in every aspect of our lives, and things can only move further in that direction from here. Hope you learned something from this video. Thanks for watching.